Ronald Seranga, the third witness in the disciplinary inquiry against the Mitiana Municipality legislator Francis Zake, today faced Zake's lawyer Erias Lukwago in the Parliamentary Committee of Rules, Discipline and Privileges. The video clip, which formed the basis of this case, was played in the committee before cross-examination of the witness. Seranga, who is a personal assistant to the Buyamba County lawmaker Javida Semwanga, told the committee that he received the video clip from a friend called Henry Mbuga, but he is not aware who exactly captured it.
For that specific video, I cannot specify the person who recorded it because at the event there were very many people taking videos, but I just know the person who shared it with me.
Lukwago asked the witness why his principal Javida, who was allegedly equally insulted in the impugned video, never took action against Zake's utterances like his counterpart Juliet Chinyamatama, the Rakai District Woman Member of Parliament.
Any formal complaint he has ever raised, either going to court or doing whatever, taking any action.
Okay, for the formal complaint, he has not raised any formal complaint.
Committee members, led by the chairperson, Abdu Katuntu, also placed questions to the complainant's witness.
The video clip?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Are you familiar with it?
Yes, very familiar.
Very familiar with it?
Yes.
How did you get to be familiar with that video?
Shared with him. So I wanted him to mention, even if two members.
To Matovu Hassani, the one that took a photo with the Honorable Zake, I also communicated it to the person, I know him by a nickname, it's called Mwambala Jini, Lukidi Mwambala Jini, Ruamavua.
The committee is, however, yet to decide whether to admit Makerere University Rakai Students Association as witnesses in the inquiry. Katuntu noted that although the group petitioned Parliament protesting Zake's conduct in the instant case, the committee needs legal guidance.
Clear on the law whether we can handle that process, what lawyers call we consolidate it together, we process both together. Alternatively, we handle that process differently. So I'm not yet so sure how we should handle it.
Lukwago was not pleased by further adjournment of this case, saying it has frustrated his client to the edge as he spends his valuable time on defense of what he calls a trivial matter. He registered disappointment with the continued absence of the complainant in the case.
The question is an understatement. It's an understatement. We are flabbergasted. Yes, because we have been made to move up and down in the corridors of Parliament. We have been made to incessantly come before the committee. And on all occasions, at least the whole of this week, the Honorable Chinyamatama, who is the complainant, has made no show, has not turned up without any reason being advanced. She has not explained. She has not even cut set to write to the committee.
The case has been pushed up to 26th March to wrap up proceedings by entertaining the remaining three witnesses. The Rakai District Woman Member of Parliament, Juliet Subi Chinyamatama, accuses Zake for allegedly insulting her in her constituency on Independence Day last year. Meanwhile, a section of members of Parliament has announced plans to start public consultations on the stakeholders' views on the Anti-Counterfeit Goods Bill 2023 ahead of its planned tabling before Parliament later this year. Consultations will run for 3 months, beginning April 2024.
We're going to begin having public consultations on as far as this bill is concerned. And as you're aware, public consultations are very crucial in legislation because these bills or these laws are made for and on behalf of the people. So we want to use this opportunity to inform the public out there that we'll be moving to the various regions of this country to engage the people of Uganda on this particular subject.
Basalirwa defended the move to enact the anti-counterfeit goods bill, arguing that Uganda has no single piece of legislation that comprehensively addresses the issue of counterfeits, and at the moment there are only pockets of one or three lines in different pieces of legislation.
Now, when you look at Uganda's legal framework, I want to confirm that Uganda has no single piece of legislation that comprehensively addresses the issue of counterfeit.
Jonathan Ebwalu decried the menace of counterfeits which continue to afflict the people of Uganda, irrespective of their political inclinations, gender, tribe or social standing, saying the proposed bill is a non-partisan people's law which should unite and heal the wounds of the political divide.
We need to come together so that we have a piece of legislation that will be able to control and manage the counterfeit in the country. It's to all stakeholders out there, special recognition to Feed the Future, agriculture inclusive markets, who are very interested in counterfeiting agriculture sector and other partners that we shall be working with. This is our law. Let us support it.
The Anti-Counterfeit Goods Bill 2023 will govern the selling, buying, manufacturing and distribution. Story compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.